Denis, can you just talk us a little bit about the challenges for you on taking a movie that people think they know, but now it's going to be expanded to a different universe?
Yeah, the thing is that's the thing that excited me about this project is that one of the things that I felt is that it is the screenwriters, they brought this universe, they allowed the characters to get out of the neighborhood where Deckard was evolving. So you'll see a bit more of the universe that is surrounding Los Angeles. Not too far, but a bit more, you know. And that I thought was a challenge for me to keep it in the same world and to keep the world homogeneous. I don't know how to say that in English, sorry. The same, to have the same qualities, but that's one of the quality of the screenplay, I think, that it expands a little bit the world.
Obviously, when you did Arrival, that kind of whetted your appetite a little bit to special effects in the world of sci-fi, but this takes it to a whole different level. How much did you as a filmmaker allow it to be computer-generated, or did you need it to be practical?
I will say, I think that the CGI, the computer imagery, is very powerful. But I'm not. It's a very difficult process. It's very. I like to do things as much as possible on camera. We try our best to do as much as possible. It's not possible to do everything, but we did. We tried, and so it means that for me it's very important because it means that for the actors, it's more inspiring, and for us, me and the cinematographer, we have more control, and you feel it as an audience when things are real in front of the camera. So we did our best to recreate vehicles, buildings, streets. It was raining for real. It was snowing for real. It was like, movie snow. But it was like we tried our best to.
I know this movie is wrapped in such secrecy, but can you just guide the audience a little bit? I know we're 25 years later after the last Blade Runner. Kind of just whet our appetite with what audiences can expect.
But the thing is that it's, again, a detective story, existential detective story, meaning that it's a character, that it's a film noir, you know, so detective that has to deal with forces and that are in the world around him that are maybe stronger than him, and that deals with the idea that they are like bioengineered humans that are called replicants, that are people that are stronger and faster and a bit more intelligent than humans, designed by humans. I mean, and they are there to help human to build other world on another planet. But they still have some problems with those beings, and for that they need to police them with Blade Runners. And we are following one of those guys, a Blade Runner detective, you know, dealing with those beings, the replicants. So it's not a good resume, sorry.